Canes will kick it away to start us off. From inside his own 10, let's see what he gets. He was looking for more running room, but none to be found as he stopped at the 23. The offense set for a first down play. They'll run the RPO and throw it right. And he'll make his way out of bounds after the solid pickup.
The quick passing game does several things. One, it doesn't let the pass rush get you. Those great defensive linemen, the ball's coming out so fast they can't get there. And then what else? It gets me ahead of the sticks. I don't have to worry about getting in long yardage and predictable situations.
And he was loose and not stopped until he gets to the 47-yard line. And let's hold on just a minute here as the officials are going to have a second look. And you know the standard is indisputable video evidence, and the officials will change the call. The offense lines up at the 41 with a first and 10. From the gun, the running back has it. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one. Man, what a spectacular play by that defensive end to come up with the tackle there.
And you see those guys get off the football so fast. Most of these guys are 250 to 275 pounds, but they get off the ball fast, low. And the offensive linemen, they have no chance to stop those guys as quick and as fast as they are.
Well, the short passing game is a great go-to for any offensive coordinator in the first quarter because it's reliable, but it also allows you to see how the defense is going to react and play. So this can certainly open things up later.
And he can't grab the bullet pass on third down.
Well, they try to throw for it there on third down on the opening drive of the game. They don't get it, but let's punt the ball away. Let's trust our defense. And, guys, let's also trust this home field advantage and the crowd to get loud and make it real difficult on our opponent.
On fourth down, they're taking to the air. And the incomplete pass, they roll the dice. Snake eyes.
And this offense chews to be aggressive. Listen, once you start getting to midfield, you see most offenses be aggressive, and they took their chance, and they failed. Now, early in the game, a chance to create momentum to swing back to the other side of the football field.
Can't find his man as he took a shot trying to deliver that football, and it'll be second down. Going for it all. And they can't hook up, going for the big play on second down. Now it's third down.
I think the QB wants that one back. You're down here in the red zone, tighter areas, hard enough to fit it in, but definitely not going to fit it in against double coverage. And he misses, and probably a good miss because that could have been worse.
Looking to throw, it's Garbers. Fires to the middle. It's caught. And it is a chunk play, a huge gain on that one before the defense brings it to an end. And the Bruins will have it first and 10. He's going to pass. Caught in the backfield, it's Harden. And the defense had that one well covered, just a short gain there. Well, he comes up with the reception, but not a lot of room to run after that.
Yeah, and I like the QB doing this. I mean, I'm going to find ways to give him the football and see if he can make a miss. And I'm going to bet most of the time that my guy is a little bit more athletic than that defensive guy. Defense won this battle, but I like trying to get this guy the ball in space.
Boy, they'd love to move the sticks here and take a shot at it on first and goal. He's got it on the run. They didn't quite get that route run deep enough to pick up the first down. Now they've got a fourth and short.
And I think everybody at home tends to yell at their television set, why aren't you getting past the first down marker? Why did you run your route short? Defense did a good job knowing where that was. But now, fourth down off.
And he will take it in. Touchdown, UCLA. A score for the big fella here. Why are tight ends so effective in the red zone?
Well, these aren't the guys that are going to burn by you and go for 70 most of the time. But when you can use their big-bodied frames, threaten them to run the football and be a blocker in the running game, and now you slip them in the secondary, make that big play.
And the extra point is good, and it's 7-0. So that drive covered just 44 yards. And they finish it off by connecting from 10 yards out. They already have the lead, and they're trying to build it here in the first quarter with an onside kick. And a few anxious moments, but the hands team is able to fall on it.
Man, these coaches talked about being aggressive, and they were. First quarter, you're going with the onside already. I would say it's a little bit careless, a little bit reckless. Onside kicks are not high percentage, but they went for it, they failed, and now let's see how they respond.
Scanning the field, it's Sanders. They're trying to get to him. And the defense will corral the quarterback, and down he goes at midfield. Man, he was back there and in the quarterback's face before the Bruin faithful could finish an ape clap.
I mean, just getting off the ball so quick, penetrating. When you got defensive linemen that can get upfield, rush the quarterback, every Bruins fan will be jacked up.
Nowhere close on that one as he got drilled trying to deliver the football, and now they face third down. I'm not positive, but that first down marker might be in the next county. A quick completion to the left, looking for the first down.
Hard work pays off, guys. These offenses work so hard week in, week out, working on those critical down distances. Third downs, having that conversion this early in the game, that's got to feel good for this offense.
Got it. Behind the line, it's Hunter. They make the stop, but the sweet pulling catch is plenty to give him a first down.
And that's just a great individual effort by the wide receiver. He catches this ball way short of the sticks, but because he's able to make the defender miss, now he's able to get the extra yards and turn that into an explosive play.
Fires to the end zone. What a snag by the defense. Delivers the contact. And they capitalize not only on the pick, but on the great return to improve this field position.
When you get in the red area, as a quarterback, you got to be dialed in. You got to be really sharp, really crisp. You have to play with great timing. The field is so shrunk. Everybody's got such a little area to cover. Fitting in it in tight windows is tough to do, and he failed on that play right there.
The offense will have to use its first timeout of the half. This should be the last play of the quarter. Pulls and throws off the RPO. They make the stop, not a whole lot of ground picked up there, and they'll have work to do to get the first down.
UCLA, 7, Colorado, 0.
Now facing a third down as they come back to the line after the break. Back to pass, it's Garbers. Unloads to the right. Can't make the connection on third down thanks to that tough, hard-nosed pass defense, and now it's fourth down. He'll try to throw and pick up the first down. Shoots it to the left. And the incomplete pass lets his defense get the ball back for his own great field position.
Yeah, and I tell you, that takes some onions to go for it in your own territory like that. I mean, they're treating this like it's a video game. They don't even care. They don't worry about the outcome. No big deal.
It's complete to the left. They pick up half of it. It'll be second and 5.
You just got to get this guy going in the offense. You got to hand it off to him. You got to throw it to him, too, on all different types of downs. I love it on first down here. Just getting him the ball in the passing game. Let him make something happen and set up second and short.
Good throw and catch. Takes it down to the 5 as the offense tries to cash in. And the Buffaloes trying to pay off the threat on first and goal. Plus the pass. And it's picked off at the goal line. That's one way to make a stop. And he's brought down, and this defense gets the ball back for its own.
And this is obviously not a great start for this quarterback here. 2 interceptions already in this game. He's got to do a much better job with his decision making.
Looking for space, it's Harden. Just plowing down the field. Really nice, patient job to find some running room by this junior. The Bruins moving the chains on the ground, and they've had some great running backs there. Some have flown under the radar a little. He lost one down the sideline. And the DB forcing the incomplete pass with the deflection. And now on second down for this offense. He's looking to throw. They're bringing heat. And the defense finally makes the stop after the sweet run and good gain. The Bruins with the first and 10. Defense trying to keep this offense from getting a line on who to block. Quarterback tried to scramble around for a while, but the defense able to bring him down. And the Bruins will hustle to the line. Looking to throw, it's Garbers. Firing to the right, complete. They bring him down, but a solid pickup to put them in position to pick up a first down. Line is set on third down. From the gun, wants to pass. And he gets it to the 45-yard line, and that'll be a first down. Here's this offense with a fresh set of downs. They'll ride the running back and leave it with him. And a nice, solid pickup there before the defense wrestles him to the ground.
Yeah, this coaching staff, they're getting this offensive line lathered up and into a rhythm. Now they're letting them drive off the ball on first down on these running plays, and they're getting chunks of yardage.
Coming after it. And the defense gets to the quarterback.
This offense is going to have to come up with a plan to block this guy. He is an absolute monster, and he showed you all his tools on that sack.
Trying to move the sticks on third down through the air. On target to the left. The offense calls timeout. It's the second one they've used this half. It's first and 10 from the 38-yard line. He wants to throw. Fires to the right. Incomplete thanks to the great defensive pressure there that sort of threw them out of rhythm. Didn't connect last time. Let's see if they throw it again on second down. They'll go to the air. He'll take the deep shot. And it's incomplete, going for the massive explosive play instead. They're looking at a third down. They line up, and it is a long way to the sticks from here. On third and long, try to convert through the air. He looks that one in nicely. That is exactly what you're looking for when you talk explosive plays. The defense finally able to make the stop. Now inside the 20, first and 10 from the 18. Getting some heat. And the defense makes a play, and they get the quarterback down at the 26. This will likely be the last play of the half. Dropping back, it's Garbers. Throws toward the end zone. And it's caught! Touchdown, Bruins!
And I love this offense, man. Staying aggressive. Just because you got the lead, you know people can score points in bunches. This offense keeps the foot on the accelerator, scores again on the final play. Now this offense has even more of a cushion going into halftime.
They want to see if they can score the deuce. Barges ahead. He won't make it in. Stopped just short on the two-point conversion attempt, and that's how this first half will come to a close. And the Buffaloes will kick it off to start the second half. From inside his own 15, looking for a crevice. And the coverage team able to make the tackle. UCLA offense is back on the field, ready to go to work. They start this third quarter with the lead, but they might want to think about shoring up that protection.
Yeah, the good news is you're leading on.
Just steamrolling his way through. Stopped at the 42, but he got 15 yards on the play. More precision throws from this Bruin quarterback, much like a Rick Neuheisel used to play.
Just pinpoint accurate. Put the ball right where you want to. You think about Troy Aikman, you think about some of those other great names in UCLA history.
That's the type of explosive play you love to start a drive with. First down from the 42. The give to the running back from the shotgun.
It's just so nice to know you can start off on first down with positive plays. Positive yards, hand the football off, set up a good second down.
On second down, looking again to throw. Takes a hit as he fires. That pass is incomplete, and they might be fortunate. It wasn't knocked free for a fumble. It'll be third down. back to throw. It's Garbers. Pocket starts to collapse. That pass not close as he got drilled trying to deliver it, and it'll bring up fourth down.
And look, I know this offense made some adjustments at halftime. They couldn't wait to get back out on the field and try to generate a score. But their defense is playing lights out. So to me right now, this is a no-brainer. After the incompletion on third, just punt it away and let your defense eat.
And they are stopped on fourth down. That decision will be questioned. And the Colorado offense is coming back onto the field. That last drive was a punch in the gut, throwing the pick in the red zone, Jesse.
Yeah, it just seemed like there was some miscommunication down there in the red zone.
And that is interception number 3 on the day. They bring him down, but that great defensive play might be overturned. Let's see what the call is. As a defense, you hate to let them move the chains on a penalty, but that's what they did. It's 1st and 10. Looking to move it through the air. The sure hands, it's Hunter. And he breaks into the open. And he'll haul it in and take it to the end zone. Touchdown, Bucks!
One of the reasons this offense is so exciting to watch, they've got guys that are dangerous after the catch. If this quarterback gets through his progression, David, he hits you in stride, these guys will take it to the house.
Man, it's your job to do the rest, right? You hit me in stride where I don't have to stop running, I don't have to break down. It makes it so easy, the connection between quarterback, wide receiver. You can tell this is a good one, and that's why they got 6 on that play.
He was looking for some running room, but not much to be found as he stopped at the 18. UCLA will go back to work on offense. We'll see if that failed fourth down in their own end last time, David, sort of curbed some of the aggressiveness.
Well, you hear about it all the time in football. Go for it. Be aggressive. The problem is when you get stopped, sometimes it puts you in a hole. And, Jesse, now the offense has to come out and respond.
They were real disappointed not getting that first down. You can see it on the sideline. So let's just see if that's kind of galvanized them a little bit here to go make a statement and get some points.
And down he goes back at the 3.
There's an example of a dude getting beat one-on-one with his quarterback getting closer and closer to his end zone, man. That's scary.
The back goes in motion. On 3rd and long, doesn't need to take the check down. The heat got to him, and he just sort of froze and got tackled in the end zone for a safety. After giving up that safety, they'll have to boot it away and give it right back to them. He will signal for the fair catch and take it just inside the 35. Colorado has the ball back, and the Buffaloes hoping to put their team in prime position on offense. Colton finds his man on the left. They make the stop after the catch, and still some work to do to pick up that first down.
And a big key on that throw to the slot receiver, guys, is putting the ball out in front. The location of the throw is what helped that guy get extra yards after the catch.
Pass, it's complete. Big, big gain on that one as he steps out of bounds with a 1st down.
And as a defense, how scary is it having to defend this guy? He's one of the fastest players in America, and you saw it on that last play. It's not necessarily throwing him the ball over your head.
Got some room, headed to the goal line. Touchdown, Colorado! And that one will put him up here in the 2nd half. When that receiver got free, it was all over.
And it's so nice to have a receiver like this as a quarterback because you pad my stats. I like those long touchdown passes where I just threw it really short, and he did the rest of the work.
And that kick was perfectly down the middle. About to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. He'll bring it out. It's Sturdivant. He stopped short of the 20 at the 19 and probably wishes he had just taken the touchback. The UCLA offense is back on the field, ready to go to work. And the last time they had the ball, they wound up giving up a safety, Jesse.
Yeah, that was ungood the last time they had the ball. So they got to do something here offensively to get into a rhythm, running and throwing the football. Try to find that consistency there.
And try to find something positive with this offense. Forget about the safety. Those don't happen very often. Try to get some first downs together. Get some good mojo now.
The Bruins get enough to move the chains. First down for this offense. Linebackers trying to create some confusion. To the air, it's Garbers. Throws to the wideout. He's got it. Really nice pickup there as they have it out to the 44 with a first down.
It's hard for an offense to win when you get in predictable situations. What a great job understanding where the first down marker is. Got to get a big game, got to get that first down. Nice job, great nose for the first down.
And he was hit just as he released it, and it falls to the turf.
And the quarterback gets hit again. We already know this defense has gotten home to him multiple times in this game. So here you are, you're trailing in the game. Defense knows you're going to throw it. They're pinning their ears back. You can't feel very confident right now if you're the play caller, and certainly if you're the quarterback, that you're going to have time to throw.
After the incompletion, they go back up top. That's caught. It's Sturdivant. Stopped after making the catch.
You just get the feeling this defense is going to make it hard on them, right? They've got the lead. It's late. And they're going to try to tackle everybody inbounds. Offense is going to have to really work for this and be smart. You got to attack the sidelines. You got to throw first down. You got to keep this thing moving vertically down the field.
He's got first down yardage as they move it to the 44. And the Bruins come to the line with a fresh set of downs. They're going to throw it again. Zings it complete to the right. He's brought down solid. Pick up but a little bit short of the first down. We have reached the two-minute warning, and time is of the essence if this offense is going to make a play. Looking to throw on second down. Caught in the backfield. It's Harden. Brought down at the 21-yard line. A 15-yard pickup, and they are in prime position to get points now. Makes his connection. Really nice job there by both guys, the throw and the catch, to work that defense and get the first down. Everybody has to be set. They have to get it off. From the gun, they'll try to impose their running game. He's knocked down in the backfield. He'll lose a couple. They'll use a timeout here. You have to be certain at this point in the game. They're looking for an advantage to the right. He's knocked down in the backfield. He'll lose a couple.
It's a bad sign on offense when you have that many people running free at the running back. That means guys up front aren't getting their blocks. Just too many hats getting the ball carried. I love his effort making multiple guys miss, but still, it's a negative play.
And a missed opportunity on third down as the defense knocks it free, and fourth down is coming up. And now on fourth down, they will put it on the shoulders of the kicker to save them with his foot. And the kicker delivers the three to salvage that drive. Field goal is good, game is tied, and how about a little drama, guys? From inside his own 15, looking for room. Maybe if he could have eluded just one or two more guys, it would have been a big return, but they'll mark it at the 30. And the Colorado offense is coming back onto the field. The offense really couldn't ask for much more than this, Jesse.
You're right. With this much time on the clock, David, the playbook's wide open. You don't have to just be throwing it every down. You can sprinkle in some runs, too.
And you find out what your quarterback's about. Big time, prime time moment. You got the ball, tie game, you want to go win. Make some plays for him, Big Dog.
Quickly complete. And a good job in coverage there as they stop it after just a few.
Hey, at this point of the game, your best players have to touch the football. It's tied. It's late. You're on your own end of the field. You're just trying to get into field goal range late here in the fourth quarter. Find your best matchups. Find your best playmakers.
Got it. Looking for a first. He's run out of bounds, but he's got enough to move the sticks. And it looks as if they've buzzed down. Replay wants to have another peek at that last play. And the play will stand after the replay booth just does a little double-checking to make sure. The receivers often will run their route based on a side adjustment. Unloads to the wideout. Got him downfield. They'll get him stopped just short of the end zone, but they're in business here with a first down.
That's a beautiful pass and catch. I love the job the quarterback does manipulating the defense with his eyes. He froze that safety. And that allowed his receiver.
And this is going to be intercepted. A big play in a tie game. And he's wrapped up after a solid return on the pick. The defense was looking for a huge play in this tie game, and they have just given their team a great opportunity.
I think, Reese, at this point of the game, tied late, it's going to come down to who can make the most plays. The defense comes up with a massive play, creating that turnover. Outstanding job by the D. All 11 guys being on the same page, now putting their offense in a great position.
Timeout is called by the defense. 19 ticks remaining.
Let's be honest, Reese. Like, the only time the fullback gets the football is usually in short yardage situations, and the defense was locked in. You got to try to get penetration with that defensive line. They did a good job of it. Nowhere to go with the football.
Makes the grab down the left side. He's loose. The tag. He is down at the one. A terrific run after the throw and catch. Timeout is called, and the clock is down to 8. He's knocked down in the backfield. He'll lose a couple. The Bruins have it with a first and 10. To the air. It's Garbers. That, friends, is a busted play. Incomplete.
You know, a lot of people are going to look at that play and say, man, that was a bad play. Didn't gain any yards. But that could be the offense maybe setting something up. The play caller is going to remember that last play. He's going to remember how the defense reacted to it, made a quick tackle. They might pump that.
Just too much heat that time, and they knock him down at the 31.
You can just see the excitement this defense has every play. They're almost wishing this quarterback drops back to throw because they know they're going to get home to him. That's the 6th time they've registered a sack.
And this is going to be incomplete on 3rd.
Really nice 3rd down sub defense there that time. It's 3rd and long. They're expecting pass. And they're mixing up their looks. They're trying to change the picture pre-snap to post-snap to confuse the quarterback. Now forcing the incompletion, setting up 4th.
The offense will use a timeout with a critical down coming in overtime. The fake, they flip it to the kicker. Did not make it. Stopped short, and they get nothing in the first possession of overtime. Down, and they'll win it with any kind of score here in overtime. Grab behind the line. It's Hunter. The Buffaloes are threatening in the red zone. Quickly complete. Is on. A walk-off touchdown in OT.
That's number 2 on the day, having a day. I mean, you know he's going to catch the football, and you know he's going to make plays after he catches.